I like having fun. I like to laugh. I like to meet people who can make me laugh. I like having fun. Yes, I like to laugh. I like having fun to meet people who laugh.
Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Tim Heidecker coming to you from Atlanta, Georgia. Second week in a row. Be back next week. I am here in my beautiful hotel room. There's no secrets anymore. We're not trying to pull the wool over your face. We've got it down pat. We've got the remote via satellite broadcast humming. We expect no issues. We're going to have a great show. We're going to talk to you, the Zoomers. We're going to talk to Clownvis and get a performance from Clownvis. We love Clownvis, so it's going to be perfect timing for that. And we're joined in Glendale. We've got the Holy Trinity assembled. Doug Lusenhoff here.
Good morning.
And Vic Berger here. Yeah, Doug, that's it. That's it. Give me some. Spread it from west to east. Back at me. Vicar.
Good
the
morning.
Vicar of Burgers here as well.
I'm here. I'm happy to be here.
Cannot hear my
Yeah,
drops.
You sound happy.
We want you the drops louder. So, is that the drops aren't loud enough, Doug?
We got complaints coming in already?
Complaints are coming in.
People who said that? Need their drops louder.
Who's complaining about this show? I've heard no complaints.
Everybody loves it.
I see nothing
People
but
love
praise.
The show.
Number one podcast.
The news came. I was going to do the announcement, Vic, mm-hmm. and you stepped all over it.
Sorry.
Stepped in the
so
mud.
So excited about it.
I know. I called you this morning. I said, are you laying down? You said, yeah, it's 5 in the morning. What do you think I'm going to do? I go, hold on. Let me conference in Doug. Doug did not answer at all. Went right into his voicemail.
So this is news to him.
It's just you and me. I said, guess what, buddy? We're the number one podcast in the world.
I applauded
number one
in my
YouTube
bed.
Channel. Mm-hmm. Right?
Number one YouTube channel and podcast at the same time.
Yeah.
It's a world record.
The only thing that's competing with us, oddly, is the After Hours podcast, which you can get if you're a member of the After Hours community at patreon.com/officehourslive.
That's number two.
That's number two. So, where's my shit?
I'm looking for it. Not with it yet. Here,
you're looking for it. Anyways, the reason we're number one is because of the great audience. So, Matt, can we just take a kickoff Zoomer here?
And absolutely. Let's talk to John Henby, our star dancer from After Hours.
Oh. John Henby. Yes, you were a big hit. Was it last week or the week before that we went to a Office Hours drop concert and the After Hours period? And focus was on John Henby. Yeah. John, are you there?
Well, I saw myself actually in the YouTube reel.
Nice.
Some kind of spacesuit. Spacing out like usual. And
where are you calling from?
Colorado, brother. Just been about a month and a half being here and visited Rocky Mountains National Park. That was crazy that day. I got a story for y'all.
Let's hit it.
There was a crazed hiker on the mountain.
Good Lord. Shit.
And I was coming down from the mountain. I got lost. I went up to Gem Lake, this beautiful lake with a snow melt. It's only fed by snow melt. Try to channel the ancestors there in the springtime. But anyways, I got lost after enjoying the lake, came back down, and this dude is lying in the mud on his knees. And this guy's trying to help him. I later find out there's two guys there. All of a sudden, these troopers come rolling up with assault rifles.
Yikes.
And like it was out of a movie. It was like out of Star Trek, you know, or Stargate, some kind of
Star
like
Trek.
Crazy.
Were they phasers?
Squad of troopers just entering your field of vision. And
I was these
like,
guys
whoa,
beam
whoa,
in?
Whoa.
I don't get the Star Trek. I could see some other thing like to Walker, Texas Ranger or something, but where's Star Trek coming from?
The guys with purple heads?
I picture these groups or something. These, what are they called? The not the Klingons.
Romulans.
The dudes Anyways. With the big...
the Dingleberries.
What about it? Now here's where I get annoyed.
Just these big squad troopers coming, rolling up and just like, I don't know. It was, or maybe the cards in Alice in Wonderland. I don't know.
What they
like,
end up doing.
Yeah, what... Conclude Whoa. The story.
They just marched in sync in sequence there, in sync. What'd they do?
Oh yes, it was very like. I was dazed from the hike, and anyways, y'all, it was just out of this world. And this dude was hitting people from behind, attacking people on the mountain. He had taken too much of something.
And be careful out there with your dosage, Colorado.
That's what I want to say to people. Be careful.
Amen. Peace and love.
Yeah, what were you on when you were hiking? Like?
I've, you know, the legal stuff outside of the park in Colorado, the good grass. But, you know, I was like, oh, my God, are they going to search me? Are they going to do the do?
Well, Matt,
just be careful out there. Watch the paranoia.
I think people might be confused. They probably think they're listening to the Moth podcast with this storytelling. You know, we're gonna get sued for copyright infringement there, because this is one of the great tales. Anything else? Anything you learned from the experience?
Sorry, Tim.
Anything you want to?
Did you wrap up? Did you camp on the trail? Were you camping on the trail?
Ah, yes, that's what I wanted to ask.
At the end, I met a good hiker from California. He was from Orange County, actually.
My leg was
hurting bad. And I was like, I don't know where the fuck I'm going. And he just, like, magically, like, led me like a guardian angel through this park.
Great.
And these beautiful golden elk. I'm Beautiful. Telling you, look.
We all have to help each other. And if you do drugs, life is too tough alone. We all have
on
to support
On this rocky road.
Thank you very much for calling in. And anyway, all the best.
Ancient aliens, let's hear the now aliens.
There you go.
Yeah. Thanks, John.
So supportive.
I like it, though, because that, like... People are into aliens these days.
We want to talk about UFOs. If you have any UFO stories, turning into Doug, your what's that show called? Coast to Coast.
Oh yeah,
George Norrie.
Who was the Art Bell? Was the original?
Art Bell.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I love that guy.
But then I like George Norrie too.
They're both great hosts of that show.
Have those guys turned in? Well, Art Bell's dead, but did George Norrie turn into like an anti-vaxxer, like a conspiracy theory Q
There's
guy?
There's no way he's taken a vax, right?
No.
There's no way.
I mean, Eric Clapton.
Information he's getting on a daily basis.
Did you hear what happened with Eric Clapton, by the way? He got the vax, and he had all these side effects with it. Did you hear about that?
I did.
His hand got even slower.
I'm trying to get there, and you cut me off.
Wait, what? I don't know.
I'm trying to.
We gotta discuss our jokes ahead of time before we roll.
Now that's a slow hand.
There we go.
Eric Clapton, what a jerk! Does anybody believe anything that guy says? I mean, seems pretty convenient that the guy that's doing—he's singing on those Van Morrison songs. He's playing on those Van Morrison songs. Those weird. Anti-COVID stuff.
He's on the new album?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He said the first...
Coincidentally, I had a side effect from the drugs. Sure you did.
Throughout the whole pandemic, he said this: the first time he found his voice was when he sang Van Morrison's new song, Stand and Deliver. Felt like he wasn't alone.
He was out of African-American artists to rip off. He had to go to the Irish.
Right.
I've taken everything I could from the blues and the reggae. Now, are there any Irish around for me to exploit?
Want to check in on the Hothead Hotline?
Yes, that's what I was going to say, Matt. The Hothead Hotline is active. We can talk to them right now.
Yeah, it's not brought to you by, but someone was generous enough to send us Hothead Hot Sauce, which is pretty fun.
It feels like I got deja vu. Did that come up last time?
No, we forgot. And I forgot who sent it. I forgot his name. He's a central time zone guy.
Hey, let me ask.
917.
What's the feedback before we do that? What's the feedback on the TV in the background? Are people hating it?
Confusion, questions. Yeah. It's kind of fun.
It's a little. Is it distracting, guys?
Yeah, definitely distracting.
Can we have Tim on this screen here? I still see the last caller. There we go.
I'll turn it off.
I'm going to have to go to youtube.com/Tim Heidecker and watch this live. I can't see Tim.
It's the only way.
Now it looks
you guys
like
can't see me?
Now we can. Well, now we can. Saw the hiker.
That was the big appeal of getting you involved in the show in the first place.
I was looking at the hiker. An opportunity.
All right. Hothead Hotline, you're on the line.
Hello?
Uh-oh.
Is this Jordan Peterson?
No, this is CG. I'm a Foley artist and an animator.
Okay, how can I help you today?
The name's CGI. That's C period G period E Y E.
Okay.
I can tune your head, boy.
How can I help you?
Well, I've just been made aware of something big in the Hollywood industry. Something to do with special effects. Something I've specialized in the last 60 years.
Okay.
Hello.
Well, it's putting me out of business. I'm a mom and pop.
Okay. Thank you very much. I understand your complaints that you don't like CGI because your name is CGI.
Hello, Max.
I think CGI was expecting a big laugh right after that.
Coincidence, if you say.
Goodbye.
Sounds like Al Pacino.
Oh,
thanks, CGI.
Sounds like Yoda. Let's take a zoomer, Matt.
Eric Bowman is the one who sent us the sauce. Thanks, Eric Bowman.
Thanks, Eric.
Thank you, Eric. That was very generous. Let's check in with Errol Pal, Julian. We haven't talked to Julian in a while. Giving us some peace and love.
Julian, how are you today?
I'm doing well. I'm on 8.5 months without a drink, so thank you very much.
There you go.
I'm going to make it quick.
I'm on
Doug.
4.5 hours.
That's great. Just really quickly, Doug, you're friends with Eric Andre, and you met Death Grips. What was that like?
Oh, it was loud.
Yeah. What was MC Ryan?
Tim
like?
Is gonna. They're nice, quiet dudes. Actually, very quiet.
I'm
cool.
Sure.
Nice fellas.
Because I huge Death Grips fan. They're one of my favorite bands, along with Queen and Stars of the Lid and Brian Eno. And
what a group. What a.
I know it's.
You have a lot of variety in your taste. It's nice.
Suffice to say, it's eclectic. But did you talk to MC Wright at all? Was there any sort of correspondence between you two?
Oh, we're pen pals now. Yeah, we we do write letters, handwritten letters, page after page of. He takes a lot of my writings and puts them into his lyrys.
I am sorry, I have to move the show along.
Look, nice guys, nice
guys, and let's have them on the show if they're willing. I'd love to have them on the show. I mean, I don't think I have anything personal against them, right? I don't remember why that. I think it was just
it was because of the Melon Man,
the Anthony Fantano. Yeah, I don't know even why. I don't have anything against anybody. Peace and love.
Tim, Vic, and Matt.
City of the day.
Love you very much.
Peace.
Take care, buddy.
Congrats on your...
We do not stop right. The city of the day. City of the day keeps trying to tell me where I am. The city of the day is brought to you by... City of the Day is brought to you by Levi's Bell Tops. That's right. Famed guitarist
Steve Vai.
His son, Levi, has new jeans.
Run.
Listen up, kids. Skinny jeans aren't cool anymore, and bell bottoms are never coming back. That's why you need a pair of Levi's new bell top jeans. That's right, Levi, son of Steve Vai, is now making jeans. And what makes bell top jeans cool? The wide part is at the top, so they're comfortable and stylish. Plus, you won't have to worry about wearing a belt. Just clip on some suspenders and you'll be styling. Levi's bell top jeans are practical too. They're perfect for delivering watermelons. Just fit one big old watermelon right in the front there. In fact, they provide up to 8 cubic feet of storage, so no need for backpacks either. Levi's jeans are now available at Kohl's. And the actual city of the day, this is kind of neat. The actual city of the day is a new code. What week are we on? Is this the second or third week of the new code?
This is the second.
Second week, yeah.
Second week of the new code, brought to you by Vic Berger. And that's a clue right there, I think. City of the day is Cheyenne, Wyoming. Great home of the Cheney family, the Cheney dynasty, the Liz Cheneys. The Liz Cheneys out there causing trouble. Weather is high of 65, low of 44. And ever spend any time out there, Doug?
I've been to Wyoming a little bit. Very mm-hmm. crazy place.
There you go. Great nightlife.
Yeah, nightlife.
I was in what's it called, Jackson Hole, when I was a kid. For my father had a business meeting out there. Conference.
I snowboarded at the Jackson Hole once, but it wasn't really. There was no hole. It was more of a hill.
By the way, I am so hungry. I got totally distracted and realized that we're here on the East Coast, and usually this show is a morning show, and I totally forgot. So I have some Postmates coming soon, and I apologize for that because I know you don't. I won't eat on the show, but you can now do Postmates to hotels and everything.
What'd you get?
I got some Thai food. Oh, that's...
Oh, my God. What are the chances?
Wow.
That's crazy. I guess that was 30 minutes ago. Yeah.
Do you want me and Vic to interview someone while you get that?
Sure, yeah. Bring on a caller.
Or I could just do a drop concert.
Yeah, just do that.
Just give a couple drops.
Yeah, just leave it right there. I'm just doing a live show right now. That's great, thanks.
All right, I think you're paid up. So,
are you? Wait, are you guys?
I don't mean to interrupt. Sorry, you. No. You're going
wait,
on
what
here.
The heck?
This looks like you know who this is, what? Or it looks like.
It sounds like.
It sounds like. Is that
wait,
Phil?
Can you get who is that guy?
Phil? Phil?
Dead ringer.
No, not.
Can you take your. It's safe in here. I'm vaccinated.
You're okay, yeah, I'm too. But just
that's Phil Braun.
Oh my gosh, Phil! Are you a Postmates delivery driver now?
My name's not Phil, but
what is your name? Who is this? I'm freaked out.
Well, it's kind of weird you say that. I got a brother named Phil, but
you have a brother named Phil. What's your name?
My name is Bill.
Your name is? Are you Bill Braun? Is that what your name is?
Yeah.
What the hell? Here, listen.
Wait, what?
Headphones here. We're doing a live YouTube show here.
Okay.
I'm so freaked out. I'm sorry. We have your, I guess your brother, Phil Braun, is a caller on our show. He calls in and does bits and stuff.
We were supposed to have Phil on today, weren't we?
You know, there's a show he mentions. I've never heard of it, though, but
it looks just
weird.
Like you look. I mean, obviously, you're twins. You look. You're identical twins.
I do have a twin brother, Phil Braun, if that's the same guy you're talking about.
Yeah.
Is he
this is amazing. Like,
what are the chances?
I'm flipped out here. What are the odds of you being the one that delivered my food, too? I'm sorry, because we just... Is Phil in the Zoom
today?
Let me
see if he's in the... let me see. Oh, yeah, he is actually in the Zoom, yeah.
Oh, wow.
You see Phil there? Phil, are you there?
Okay.
Hey, Phil. Are you there? I can't hear him.
Good. Well, I had a good bit here prepared today. I thought I'd dust off the old Smokey and the Bandit routine. I know that didn't go so well the first time I tried this, but I think I've really kind of got this one nailed down here So,
well, we got your somebody here, a guest here. I don't know if you can see
my screen. What's he doing there? Yeah. Hey, Phil. Good to see you. This is kind of weird.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm really. I mean, I'm. What just I mean is, food is here. Are you this there? Is kind of odd.
He's delivering food
to
here.
Come down. I wasn't invited to come to the hotel. Be there in person.
I apologize. Like I said, I didn't.
I wasn't invited either. I'm just here to deliver food, bud. So I don't know what you're talking about. But
I want you to tell me where you guys are at. Tell me the hotel you're at right now.
I don't want to reveal the hotel because then I have a bunch of people coming down here. I apologize, Phil.
Just give me the hotel and give me the room number, please.
Look, customer policy doesn't allow me to do that. No. I'm sure he doesn't want to do that. No, so I would advise you not to do that.
Phil, it's nothing personal. I didn't know. I didn't call for your
honestly,
brother. I didn't
God
know
damn
you
it.
Had a brother.
I would
don't
cut
you
him
don't
off.
Disconnect me, God damn it, Bill. I'm technically your older brother. Do not disconnect me.
Phil,
I'm coming
calm
down.
Down.
Give me
right?
the information to come down
was,
there.
Totally
I'll be down there in like
occurrence.
20 minutes, okay? Do
Phil,
not
relax.
Do not turn this off.
I would
not
just,
mute
I'd
me.
Just
I swear.
Him or cut him off.
I am a big part of the show.
Can we dump Phil? He's
a very big part of the show.
He's unstable.
I don't know why he's there.
Phil, please.
I don't know what's going on.
Phil, we'll talk to you later. I apologize.
Tell me where you're at.
Just cut him.
So,
no, just
what's
cut
he
going
to do if he comes down there?
I know.
Like, why does he want to
No, he's like right away wants like, to get up at my face.
Yeah.
Why is like, he so mad?
So scary.
This is just kind of how he is.
Really?
He gets all worked up over things on social media a lot. He horns himself in places where he doesn't really belong. So
yeah.
I apologize on my behalf. That he's behaving that way, but so, it's frankly, it's not very surprising.
Really?
That
yeah. So
there.
You. So yeah. Let me ask you, Bill, if you don't mind. You got a few minutes, or?
Sure. Yeah. I'm kind of at the end of my shift here, so this is my last delivery.
We don't actually know very much about Phil. Like he calls in and does some funny things. And,
okay.
Like, what's the deal with him? What's the problem?
How long here? Do you have?
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. He's my brother. He's older than me by a month. We're twin brothers.
what does that
what
mean?
Happened there?
Yeah.
It just that's another story, but it's a weird.
No, it sounds like a good story. So your mother was pregnant with identical twins, gave birth to Phil, but then held you in for an additional month?
Yeah, I was born a month later.
Unbelievable.
It's a rare circumstance
never heard
that happens, but this happened to us. But we were both fine, you know.
And you're no disrespect to the working people out there, but you are, you're a Postmates delivery guy.
That's one of many jobs that I have right now. As a matter of fact, the coincidence here is just kind of unreal because I'm doing this job. I've got another job where I'm doing, when I get off of this shift, I'm going to take like a 3-hour nap, go to my in-home care job where I work from the 8 p.m. to 8 a.m. shift there.
Wow.
Oh, wow. Work weekends because, to be honest, not to just divulge all of our family info, but I've had to bail Phil out quite a number of times.
Yikes.
He's in a lot of trouble,
mm-hmm.
some bad investments, some Clooney thing that he brought up,
right,
and he claims
right.
he knows him, which we kind of doubt, but he's in a mountain of debt there. One time he had some apes destroy his house and insurance scam
that,
and we had to unravel all that. It was just a nightmare, but
that's terrible.
Yeah.
Well, guys, do you have any questions? We have this amazing opportunity here. We got Bill Braun here, brother of Phil Braun. Any questions that it's on your mind, Doug?
What job does Phil do?
That's a good question.
Does he have a job?
We never know what is going on with him. Like,
it seems like he has a lot of free time.
Yeah,
he does have a lot of free time.
Why does he have so much free time to do what he wants?
He claims he's an entrepreneur, but we don't really know. I don't keep in close contact with him. I haven't spoken to him in 6 months. My last interaction with him was last Thanksgiving. There was a big blow up there. He got mad because grandma was wearing a mask and he said that the mask spooked him or something. He demanded to take it off. And
what kind of mask was
big,
it? It was like a Halloween mask?
No. He didn't want her to wear this mask. And we were like, no, grandma's got to wear this.
Right.
Big fight. Mm. Haven't spoken to him since, but he.
Well, there he was today. Spoke to him today.
What was Phil like as a kid? What were his
That's
hobbies? And did he have friends?
He had some friends. Yeah, I mean, he's kind of funny, kind of a funny guy, but he's not always. He's kind of hit or miss. You know.
As an older brother, did he kind of pick on you? Is there that kind of dynamic? He was kind of.
No, he didn't do that. But you know, he was. He always getting in trouble at school. Like he ran for as a kid. You mentioned. I remember he ran for class president in third grade, and basically created some scandal where he plagiarized a Peanuts comic strip, and that was kind of his whole speech. Oh. it's been gone down from hill from there.
All right. Well, thank you, Bill, for delivering the food.
Oh, you're welcome.
Sorry to put you on the spot here on the show.
No, but, it's fine. I'm this is just you know weird circumstance, but.
Really, it is.
Enjoy the show, I guess.
Yeah. Anything else, guys? You said so.
No, I was just amazed at like how identical it is. It's you know, it's cool.
Well, this Phil looks a little heavier than.
Yeah.
I mean, Bill looks a little heavier.
Phil, a little chunkier. Yeah.
Bill looks heavier.
I'm a little more active. Phil's a homebody. Doesn't really work out.
Hey, Bill, do you have?
You look heftier than Phil. No offense.
Well, I'm always eating because I'm delivering food and I'm.
You eat some of the food.
Do you take bites out of the delivery? The food you deliver.
Take bites out of the delivery.
Not yours. I'm not saying.
Anybody's.
I mean, you're recording, so.
Yeah. All right. Well, no judgments here. Thank you, Bill.
Yeah. Nice to meet you guys. Yeah. And
you better take those headphones. Don't walk away with those headphones.
Thanks, Bill.
No. Okay. All right.
Enjoy your food.
Yeah. No worries.
Kind of wanted to keep talking to him. I have some questions. Yeah. You know.
That's the. Wait, what are you doing
leave.
There?
He didn't leave.
Where are you going?
Mind if I use the restroom real quick?
no, are you gonna fine. Tip I mean, this? Are you gonna give him a 5-star rating or?
I don't know. Yeah, I look at these fucking. Look at how wet these are.
Look, I
these are soaking. Oh, look at Vix.
And I don't understand. Like I'm wearing like I don't whatever this fabric is. I don't think it like water goes through it, but it does.
That's why you got a triple layer like me.
Yeah.
Guys in there going to the bathroom. Okay. That's Bill Braun.
Interesting.
Friend of the show, I guess. Phil is still in the Zoom, or
I think I
did he?
There?
I don't know. He was mad.
He was fuming. You might have to ban him for a week or two.
Let's take a regular Zoomer here. Let's just see what the folks think about this twin Braun situation.
Yeah, let's talk to Liv. Oh wait, where'd she go? So my screen jumped around there. Sorry about that. Let's talk to Zachary Harris.
Well,
President Zachary Harris.
Well,
are you ready, Zach?
Hey guys, yeah, I'm ready. How's it going?
What's up?
Oh, now. Pretty good. How are you?
Piggy.
I'm good. I'm good.
Okay.
I guess I have a question for Doug, if that's okay.
Yes, sir. I'm taking questions all day today.
Are you trying to usurp my show, Doug? What is going on here?
Yeah, these are plants. I planted these guys. I'm paying them to ask me questions to give me some shine on the show.
Better not be about...
yeah, thanks for that, Doug.
Please don't
Any
be
bands,
about death grips.
No death grips.
No skateboarding or death grips, please.
Not. I really like your song, Habitat, and I was just curious if you had any like writing process tips or like do you write your music sort of like by yourself at home or do you have like a more extensive process?
Well, that's tough. My friend Cool Z did the beat. It was a collab with him. And then I kind of came up with the concept and then the writing the lyrics is very tough. It's a very difficult thing to do. You just come up with words and then you have a deadline. You got to just come up with something.
Two complicated life forms getting to know each other.
But thank you. I think that song is pretty cool myself.
Yeah. What's it called, Doug?
It's called Habitat. It's a rap song.
Is it about the coffee shop?
It's not.
where can we find that? I'm not familiar with this.
You know, I should have made a music video or something for it because it kind of like nowadays you got to have a video. Otherwise, no one's going to listen to your song.
Right.
You got to get it on MTV.
It's on Spotify. It's on...
This guy Phil's, by the way, he's been in the bathroom now for a couple of minutes. What do you think is going on in there?
Do you do music, Zoomer?
Yeah, I do sort of just as a hobby by myself. nowadays, and sometimes I find it like hard to get inspired just sort of being by myself and stuff.
Dude, that's exactly where I'm at right now. It's tough.
Gotta go outside. Go outside.
That's kind of what this song is about. It's about going outside and
listen to the birds in the air.
Exactly.
Right.
Can't force it too. You just gotta let it pass.
Did anybody? I brought this up with the guys. They didn't seem very interested in it. But the
thank you, Zachary.
Thank you, Zachary.
The 60 Minutes YouTube UFO, the 60 Minutes UFO story. Did you watch it? Did anyone see this?
I didn't.
I saw a little bit. It's pretty.
What do you think? I want to poll the room. Doug, what's going on?
I didn't see it, but.
But you know.
What's the gist of the? What's the latest? Basically, they're seeing UFOs every single day.
That's what the fuck. That's what the Air Force are saying. They're saying that when we go up there, not everyone's saying every day, but that there's this pattern of years and years of documenting unidentified flying objects in the sky by military. They don't know who it is. They don't know what it is. It doesn't make any sense from like a physics standpoint.
They're zipping around way too fast. They're clearly not a person in there. Otherwise, their organs will be liquefied.
right. Yeah.
Ian Corrigan in the chat has.
So maybe they're Chinese drones and they're spying on us. That's one. Or it's extraterrestrial.
But this one dude said, this one pilot said, this thing dropped 80,000 feet in 1 second. Like, I don't even understand what that means. Mm-hmm. It's like, huh?
Well, that's. Definitely how they're not there. There's no human inside there. There would be.
Right. I feel like there'd be more solid proof though at this point. If they're happening every day, why can't they get like a real good footage of it?
They do. That you can watch. There's these little like radar things.
Yeah,
where
I've seen that. Footage. But it's why like, can't it's they like, update
that cell phone?
The
footage.
iPhone has 4K, 8K. How come these military planes can't have some high-res photos? Like,
this shit's happening like above the clouds, like up in the higher atmosphere. So how are you going to take a picture of that?
But couldn't like people like on the ground, ordinary citizens, like send some kind of signal up to track things that are going fast in the sky, right? You know what I mean? Like, can't they do that? I don't know.
I don't know what I'm talking about, but put together a UFO viewing crew and they're just go up in blimps with like high res cameras and they're just filming everything.
That's what they're doing.
No, it seems like they're flying around on some other thing, and then they see it, and then they catch.
All right, Matt, who's joined us now?
Ian Corrigan,
60 Minutes fake.
He has a site with probably
300. What is it? I can't remember if it was the hypernormalization in that Adam Curtis documentary where they were like, let the media just like advertise all of these UFO sightings, and it was just a way to cover up all the new technology that they had rolled out.
I like women, not men.
Right.
So like, I guess I'm just, it's like, yeah, it's like, oh, what is it? Like in Arizona, like with the Arizona lights, it was just like a lot of weapons testing. But then they were just like, oh yeah, we're just like this. I don't know if it was the FBI or the CIA that was just like, we'll just let media go like ham on all this brand new technology because, you know, it's like, easier to produce it and keep it secret if people are like, oh, it's this like woo-woo UFO stuff.
Right. Right.
Wait, what?
So it's a distraction by...
our minds are occupied by these things.
Okay, so that's another way to... Another theory. It's like a double cross conspiracy
double
theory.
Switch.
Where they put these fake UFOs up there. And then, meanwhile, they're all siphoning billions away from the American workers.
I mean, could be. But that's all I have to say.
My only thing is, like, I'm not like a ghost guy. I'm not like a paranormal guy. But I do always reserve the possibility for, you know, extraterrestrial stuff, because it seems like within the realms of possibility in physics. And, you know, if we're going to Mars, why can't they be coming here? So what is it that crazy?
Right.
Not that crazy.
I mean, I believe that it could be UFOs. I absolutely do. But I also do I just remembered that from the documentary where he was like this thing. And I have seen a UFO and it was in Arizona and it was crazy. That was the only time I've ever seen an unidentified flying object. I was driving towards out of the Grand Canyon and like into, it was basically from I think southern Utah into Arizona, and like kind of saw like sand dunes and like ridges. And then my ex-girlfriend and I were like, saw these red lights that looked like like phone towers. And as we got closer, I was like, that's crazy. It was filling the whole side. Our whole field of vision was just like these red lights. And whoa. As we got over this crest, there was no towers. There was nothing. Like the closer we got, we're like, we got to see all these towers. It's like insane that they built all these. Like I'd never seen that before. And then when we got there, there was just nothing. And it was just these red, it looked like string lights, but it was like throughout the whole sky. And it was pretty crazy. I was like, I don't know. My dad works for, or worked a long time for Raytheon. So like, I just think that there's plenty of stuff that's getting developed that we just have no clue about.
Maybe there's,
hey, buddy, are you taking a shit back there?
Maybe there were stoplights and then they turned green. Were they green?
Turned green. they turned blue because it was the sky.
Take a shit?
Was it daytime?
Yeah, it was during dusk. It was right at dusk. Yeah, but that was weird. Happened. That was it.
Thank you for your point of view. Sorry, Phil. Bill, I'm sorry. I keep calling you Phil because I know Phil. You look like him.
You just
took a shit in there.
Yeah, I don't mean to interrupt.
Was it an emergency? Like you had to
look when I'm doing these.
Did you have diarrhea?
Well, I'm on the road all day. I don't get a chance.
Yes, stinks.
I don't get a chance to the bathroom, so I apologize. Nasty. But,
it's awful.
I don't know who I like better now, Phil or Bill. Stuff.
Star rating here. I don't know if you had a chance to.
I didn't get in there yet. I'm doing the show, Bill. So. Can you run the air?
Open a window.
I'll do that. But
I can't open the window, Vic. It's one of these hotels. It stinks. It's like shit coming from
what
Bill.
What do you eat before this, Bill?
Related to my brother or not?
Did I give you? No, I didn't give you a star yet.
Low because of that.
I didn't rate anything. Away from me.
Could you maybe let me wait until you're done here, and then you can give me a 5-star because I really got to have a high rating here. To keep
yes, I'll
job.
Give you a 5-star.
Don't you have other deliveries to do, Bill?
Yeah, Bill.
For a lot of other stuff.
I'm going to give you 1-star for the shit smell you left in my bathroom. Now get out of here. Jeez. That is awful.
He's still going to hang. He's hanging out?
He's sitting here. He's just going to sit there?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm doing a live show right now. I'll call security and ask you to leave.
But security might kick you. If you're doing a live show, Tim, it might not be allowed.
If I don't get this 5-star rating, that's the only reason.
All right, he wants a 5-star rating. Just sit and hang out. We got to.
We can sort this out.
All right.
We can fix that,
okay? Jesus, Braun, pain in the ass.
These brothers are kind of identical, you know what I mean?
Well, they are.
I thought they were a little more different, but.
No, they are the same. Yeah, personality. I'm seeing the same personality.
Yeah, we're starting to find out.
Yeah. He's just sitting here looking at me. Let's see if I can watch this.
What are y'all talking about?
Talking about you.
Talking there or something?
I can't. You're not on mic, so it's not a good environment.
We can't hear him actually. But
you can.
Yeah,
it's a great mic. All right, look. Can we get the show back on track? Let's take another Zoomer.
Let's check in on the Hothead Hotline.
Matt, you're probably like crowing over there because I was like, hey, we should talk about UFOs, and you're probably in the back of your head going like, it's boring. And I'm thinking, hearing that guy talk about UFOs, I go, yeah, it is boring.
I just think it's in the name. It's unidentified, so we just don't know. And to leap to a conclusion that it's extraterrestrial is like, I don't, who knows? Maybe, but who cares? Also, what's the thing? What is it? Is it Occam's Razor? Where it's like, what's the most likely?
The most logical.
Yeah, what's the
simple.
Most? It's usually that. Because like one time, for about 5 or 6 seconds, I was convinced that I saw a UFO, and I was driving at night, and this truck, which I didn't know at the time was a truck. I was going up a hill and the truck was going around and the lights just rose up and I only saw these two lights and I was with a friend.
But you're dim-witted.
I am dim-witted. But like my face went white, and I yeah, exactly. And that's usually who sees these things. So sorry, audience out there.
Sorry, dimwits.
But like, no, I mean, if I didn't see the truck or whatever, I would have believed that I saw.
Like, which Disney, which UFO. Main character from the Disney canon would see a? Would see a flying saucer. I would think Goofy, because he's the dim-witted one, right?
Right.
That's just another way of looking at it.
Right. Hothead Liam is on the line and needs some advice. Is that what's going on?
Okay. Let's hope they do a funny voice. There's nothing better when these hotheads call in with a funny voice.
Well, am I here? Am I live?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
Oh, hello. Hi, Tim. This is Liam. I've called in before. I had a big stinker. I'll try not to make it that this time.
It's Bill Braun in my bathroom. Yikes.
I initially called for some advice because I'm going through a transition in my life, but I'm happy to talk about UFOs and aliens. I have seen a genuine flying saucer. So, no, okay.
Give me your...
Whatever you want.
I'll give you advice.
All right. So I had a long-term relationship recently fall apart. I am going to be moving to Florida, of all places, for grad school. And, you're going well. Things are going great. I mean, you know, it's a mixed bag, but we're doing okay. I'm going to school for writing. I write fiction. And do you have any story ideas for me, maybe? Okay. What should I write about?
Write what you know.
You're going to school for fiction, and you want to know if I have any ideas for you?
I want a freebie, Tim. Come on.
Do something else, then. If you don't have a billion stories piled up to your ears that you can't wait to tell the world about. You know what I mean?
You know, I've seen things. I've been through.
Let me guess. You're
Wait, I got,
one
of, I got, man, I got a story idea.
Let me guess. You're a Gen Z. Gen Z?
I'm 31 years old, Tim.
Yeah, you're worse. You're a millennial. All you can't work. You can't lift up the shovel. You can't come up with your own shit.
It's too
you have
much.
To rely on everybody else. It's so hard.
I got a good story
idea.
Then
you don't have to be a creative person.
Nobody's can I have Doug's story,
your head
story
you have
idea?
To be a creative person. If you don't have a story to tell, you're
there's
not
nothing original anymore.
I have so many great ideas.
Should I give
well,
up?
Then
what should I do?
Be like Bill Braun and be a Postmates worker and get stories by living in the real world.
Yeah, I can tell you, no. Phil does not have any creative any juice at all.
Sit down. Your breath stinks. You got to brush teeth before you go out and do a delivery job. That's key. That's number one. That's my big advice.
Okay. That helps. Again, I'm stinking up the show. I'm very sorry.
Hang up. Live your life. And if you've got some stories that you can't, that is driving you crazy because you have to tell them, write them down and try to sell them. If not.
I did sell a story recently. Can I plug it? Maybe people will read it when it comes out in August.
Sure.
Okay. It's going to be on a website called The Forge. It's a literary magazine, and it's I think it's a pretty good story. It's about it's corn horror. So I think Doug would probably like it as a big corn fan. I will eat the leftist ass. The vegetable, not the new metal band.
Oh, I thought you were saying porn.
You say corn?
No, corn with a C, corn. Like creamed or popped or on the cob.
So, like Children of the Corn.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. It's Children of the Corn fan fiction.
And where do you see this again?
The erotic content.
It's a literary magazine called The Forge.
The Forge. Okay.
It's online. It'll be out in August. August 3rd is my publication date. They paid me $75 for this bad boy.
Well, we might be talking to the future Ernest Hemingway here. We don't know. Yeah. Wish you all the best. Thank you for calling the hotline. Hey, Vic, you follow this stuff all the time. Did you see your old friend Joe Rogan was on The Daily, Michael Barbera. Did you hear about that?
I did.
We found this online. Check this out. Joe Rogan from the Joe Rogan podcast made a drop by. He's usually interviewing other people, right. But he swapped things around. I guess he's doing promotion. Right. I don't know what he's doing promotion for, but right. He was on The Daily with Michael Barbaro. Listen, he said some controversial things here. Let's take a listen.
You can never be woke enough. That's the problem. Mm-hmm. It keeps going. It keeps going further and further and further down the line. Mm. If you get to the point where you capitulate, where you agree to all these demands, it'll eventually get to straight white men are not allowed to talk.
Okay.
Right.
Because it's your privilege to express yourself when other people of color have been silenced throughout history. Mm-hmm. It will be you're not allowed to go outside because so many people were imprisoned for so many years. I mean, I'm not joking.
No, I know. I know.
It really will get there. It's that crazy. Mm-hmm. You know, we just got to be nice to each other, man. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of people that are taking advantage of this weirdness in our culture. Mm-hmm. And then that becomes their thing. Mm-hmm. Their thing is calling people out for their privilege, calling people out.
Well
said. Position.
Hmm. You know, very interesting.
Fucking crazy times.
Yeah, most definitely. But I do feel like
very interesting.
Well said. Theo Balcom, Andy Mills, Lisa Kim, Rachel Questor, Lindsay Garrison, Amy Brown.
Straight white men are not allowed to talk.
Mm-hmm. Sounds like a dope band.
Straight white men not allowed to talk. Straight white men not allowed to talk. Straight white men not allowed to talk.
God. The guy with the biggest megaphone on the planet.
Oh, what an asshole. I'm talking over here. I'm a straight white guy. One of the greats.
Yeah, but you're inside. Prove to me that you can go outside.
Imagine if he uses, that's like, the, for good.
It was unbelievable. I tried to leave my hotel the other day. They go, nip, back inside, pal. Where do you think you're going, whitey? You're in. Oh boy, Joe Rogan, boy, who pays attention? I mean, we pay attention to the lap, but man, Lord, keeps going. Who was the guy that he was with talking to there? I know it was not Michael Barbaro. That was what we call a routine, a bit.
Yeah, I don't know who that was.
Find out who that is, because the poor guy. I think
probably knows.
He's a comedian, and he's these poor comedians out there. I mean, whatever. I don't feel too bad for him, but. They gotta do that circuit. You gotta do that Rogan circuit. It feels like career suicide if you don't. I guess you have to have a pair of stones to say no to Roe. Who is it?
Does anybody in the chat?
I don't know. No one's weighing in, but I can't figure maybe it out. Clownvis knows because Clownvis is here.
Oh, there we go.
Clownvis is here already?
Clownvis is here. It's.
I'm not even ready.
You're not ready for Clownvis?
I gotta do some prep.
Need a minute? All right, take a minute.
Bill, are you friends with, are you a fan of Elvis Presley?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Yeah, Elvis is pretty cool.
Have you ever heard of Clownvis?
No, I have not.
Come over here. Look at this. It's going to blow your mind. This is pretty cool. This is,
Put my glasses on.
This is...
Joe List is the guy.
Joe List, okay.
Joe Rogan and Joe List.
Cool.
Clownvis, are you there?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm here. Can you guys hear me?
Loud and clear.
Hey, Clownvis.
There it is.
Wow.
Look at that.
Hey,
so
guys.
He's a clown, but he also does an Elvis impression.
I can see that.
Yeah.
He looks pretty cool.
Now you're telling... That's not Phil.
No, this is Bill. This is Phil's twin brother. He's a Postmates
Even
delivery
Clownvis
man.
Clownvis can't tell the difference.
Wow.
Phil has a beard. I don't know if you saw him earlier on the show. Phil, traditionally,
yeah, and this guy's chunky.
He's a little chunkier, a little heavier.
I mean, I don't know how you would be qualified to say something like that. But...
He's seen Phil. He's been able to see Phil. He's a fan of the show.
I do got to get rid of some of that down here.
I hear you. You see me? I'm always pulling at it.
But well, you look great, Clownvis. Nice to see you and meet you. I'm curious as to what your thing is.
Yeah, what's your thing, Clownvis?
Man, I got a lot of things, you know. I'm an entertainer, you know, is my paid profession, you know. Performer, entertainer is what I do.
And how's that been? You know, are you you've had a tough year, obviously not been able to perform live due to the pandemic and the coronavirus, COVID-19. how's that been? And are you seeing a light at the end of the tunnel? Or are we going to see some Clownvis in person in the coming months?
You know, believe it or not, and I'm careful when I say this because I know what a terrible year it was for everyone. for Clownvis, it really was a productive year. I've been, you know, Tim, you know, I've been a road dog for years. I just tour around and do clubs, and
yeah,
that's fun. But good God, stopping that, I don't miss it. You know what I mean?
Caught your breath a little bit, huh?
Yeah. And what I did when all my tours got canceled, I went directly to doing a regular program online, you know, like Office Hours style.
Nice.
And found that that opened up so much creative opportunity, and you can make money that way these days, you know, if you're smart about it and you have things to offer for people. Mm-hmm. You know, I found that I can bring in almost the same money with much less overhead, and I don't have to be, you know, getting ready in a sewage room and sleeping at a Red Roof Inn. So I don't really miss it. I will, of course, I'll get back to live performing. But I don't have the itch to just hit the road. You know, I'm happy on the internet. I'm very happy on the internet.
You know what? I know we've spoken before. Maybe I've said this before. My thing with you is always, you have a first impression of what this is going to be. You have sort of a, oh, that's funny, that's clever, that's cute. But then when you see your performance, your actual act, it's a five-star act. It's a class act. It's a fun time.
Can this guy sing?
Thank you.
Guy sing? I sure think he can. Can we get a performance from you right now?
Of course, yeah, man. I got two things I was thinking about. First, I want to try this. This is just
a little good show something. To try things. You don't have to know if it's going to work or not.
That's what I'm saying. Just a little workshop action, you know. Oh, hold on, I lost the lyrics.
Can I ask a question while you're looking something up?
Yeah, go for it.
Are you sort of the result of what would happen if Elvis in the movie Roustabout had joined the circus?
That's a pretty smart connection. Yeah, that's the only time that Elvis had a real clown connection was that movie.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, man, of course. Hi, Doug.
What's up, Clownvis? I'm just curious. Are you more clown than Elvis or more Elvis than clown?
Honestly, I'm not much of either, man. I just kind of, you know, it's just I'm a guy that got stuck in a gimmick, Doug. What do I do? No, honestly, it works real well. But when I started at the beginning of this whole thing, you know, 15 something years ago, the idea was to be an anonymous Elvis impersonator and get gigs at nursing homes and store openings and regular anonymous stuff that I could, you know, just not have to have a regular job. And that morphed into just doing stuff with bands and doing stuff at comedy clubs and becoming a vessel where I can really get any idea I have out through this situation that I'm doing here.
Now, Clownvis, let me ask you a question, Clownvis. Why didn't you put makeup on for your appearance today? Is there something you have against me? Are you just phoning this one in? Or
I like to come on like I wake up. You know, you see these guys in Hollywood, and Tim, I've seen, you know, the hipsters on your show. I know they wake up at 6 a.m. They sit in a makeup chair till noon, so it looks like they woke up at 6 a.m. I just cut out the middleman. This is it's who I am. You got to be yourself.
Ladies and gentlemen, did you fall into an acid vat or something? Is this a result?
Oh, like the Joker from Batman. I don't know.
A lot of backstory.
Let's see what happens here. Then I got another question for you.
All right. I've never played this one before, but I want to try it right now. Oh, when you look in the mirror, you know who you see. You gotta be looking for a woman like me. Hold on, I'm gonna do it. When you look in the mirror, what do you see? You know you gotta be looking for someone like me. I'm working real hard to be who I am. Don't forget the reason why you gotta love her. Yeah. You guys know this one?
Oh, yeah, I know it.
Brick by brick, we're going side by side.
All right.
And we're riding on the midnight of night, fucking wings of a turtle. That's
nice, thank you. Big legendary song from The Office Hours.
I have bigger hits.
Let me ask you a question before you have to do another song. Have you found Elvis, the love people have for Elvis, increasing or diminishing, or how is the, where is Elvis at in the minds of the people these days?
As far as, like, you know, I think the TikTokers and beyond, he's nothing, you know. It don't he means as much as Clark Gable or something, you know. It's just some
he ain't nothing but a hound dog.
I think it's just, you know, he's just a name, and you know, but I think that that is equal to what's happened to the structure of celebrity in general. You know, I think the whole structure of celebrity is kind of crumbling. So to be the top dog that did the top thing, I mean, you know, there was guys like that in jazz and blues, and nobody knows their names either. And you know, I'm not saying I'm not a fan.
Do you think he's still more higher ranked than the Beatles?
Yeah, I know this is a Beatles show, so I'm going to bite my tongue.
There you go.
Did you see the latest FBI report where Elvis was throwing the Beatles under the bus to President Nixon?
No.
I know all about that. Yeah, he said the Beatles were. He said that the Beatles were influencing the America, and he was going to. That's what he was talking to Nixon about, was the bad influence of the Beatles.
Wait, but wasn't that in the 70s?
Yeah. What are you talking about?
Elvis didn't get the memo that they had broken up, I guess.
Oh, yeah. No, that was, when was it? Probably 72 or something, I guess. When did the
1970. Beatles go to Elvis's house?
Oh, that would have been 65 or something like that.
Yeah.
Oh, what else do you have for us, Clownvis?
Tim, I wanted to plug my show. I do a show. Can I plug it?
Of course.
It's called Clownvis to the Rescue. We also air here on youtube.com/clownvispresley. And you can learn all about it if you go to clownvistotherescue.com. Tim, do you remember the first time we met?
I do not. No, I don't.
Can I tell you about it? I'm kind of embarrassed to tell this story. And I would preface it by saying that I am your biggest fan these days, you know, and
to tell it, by all means, you don't need to tell it.
No, I want to tell it. It's funny. I was laughing about it in the shower. I said, maybe Tim would like this.
Thinking about me in the shower. Go ahead.
Like I said, I want to say that from when you started on Cinema, from when this show started on Facebook, I've loved it all since I've known you. So, you know, and that was probably 10 years ago that we met. So it was at a Neil Hamburger show.
Naturally.
And, I had just met him, and it was at out in Silver Lake. And he said, Tim from Tim and Eric is going to be on the show. And I'm embarrassed to say, dude, I did not know who Tim and Eric was. I hadn't had a TV in 10 years or so. And it, you know, especially not cable or anything. So it just wasn't on my radar. And so this is where it's funny. In my head, I said, oh, he's Tim and Eric. They must be morning FM DJs. You know, I thought you were like a morning zoo. Tim and Eric
in the morning.
and then when you came backstage, right, and I was going on right after you, I said, hey, good luck out there, man. And this is just when you were, I believe, starting to do your stand-up guy.
Yeah.
You know, you're doing your stand-up routine. And you said, oh, I'm just going to go out there and bomb. And and I was like, well, that's a modest thing for an FM DJ to say, you know, like, he probably is nervous. I go, no, man, it's going to go great. These people are going to love you, you know? And then you went up on stage, and I was backstage, so I couldn't see it, but yeah, you bombed. It was just silence. And then, you know, this was before, I think I didn't have Google on my phone. I learned pretty quick. And then, like I said, became your biggest fan, but,
Oh, well, thank you.
You know, the first time I met you was an hour ago.
I know, yeah. Bill just came in the door, and now he's co-hosting the show with me, and really missing an opportunity to get some well-needed rest. Apparently,
this is interesting. You know,
bowels are evacuated, and I guess
I haven't said hi to Vic yet. Hey, Vic, what's
hey,
up,
Clownvis,
man?
How you doing, buddy?
Good, good to see you, buddy. You guys know I'm Vic's biggest fan. I love Vic.
Yes, and I am equally a huge fan of yours. You're a family favorite as of these days too. My wife, of course, loves you, and even my kids at this point because of your show on Facebook.
Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, that's weird.
What do you do on the show? Do you perform and sing? And
yeah, I do. I try to sing a little bit because people like that, you know. But we have it's like a I have this little. You see this alien behind me? He's like my sidekick. His name's Squeeb. You guys want to talk to him? We can talk to him.
Sure. Be great to talk to him.
A lot of UFO.
I know you guys
talk.
Yeah. Hey, Squeeb, they want to talk to you. Come here, man.
Tim. Hey guys, my name is Squid.
Ventriloquist situation.
Yeah, they were Squid, we, they were talking about. They were talking about the aliens. He's from some planet that doesn't exist anymore. Been around for millions of years. But they were talking about those spaceships, and we were talking about those last night. What were you guys were talking about?
Oh yeah, those spaceships. I'm surprised you guys are just now noticing them. We've been doing that for literally millions and millions of years, just flying around out there.
Yeah. What are you? Where are you flying? What are you guys doing?
They're just doing normal stuff. They're going to CVS, they're going to Rite Aid, they're going to Walgreens. Yeah. They're just doing normal stuff, but they're aliens.
Yeah, they have CVS and stuff out in space. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's not really a big deal. I mean, if you haven't noticed yet, just forget about it. Don't even worry about us.
Yeah, that's probably the best message. Don't
no
worry.
No problem, dude.
All right.
Take care of office hours.
Okay,
I love
bye.
You guys.
Nice to meet you. Okay.
Hey, Clownvis, can I ask a quick question?
Of course.
You ever do a show with David Lieberhart? Seems like a...
We did a Neil Hamburger show once at the same venue. That
Yeah, I've seen you at the Satellite many times. That's excellent. Always the greatest show.
Now, is this controversial? Did you... You had an issue online a few months ago because somebody did a bit that that was part of your routine. Don't
yeah,
you know what I'm talking
yeah.
about here?
The sucking on a chili dog bit.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Which I've done in my live show for years, where I start singing that Jack and Diane song, but mm-hmm. it's all sucking on a chili dog. And man, I've done that for,
I've seen you do it years ago. Yeah.
I was going to say, I'm embarrassed to say I've done it for like too long, you know, but it's a very, it hits every time. And, sure enough. Yeah. On TikTok, this guy did pretty much verbatim, you know, I mean, he
sucking on a chili dog, sucking on a chili dog. How do you do it? Give us a little taste of it, please.
All
please.
Right. This is, it's kind of a,
good.
Well, it's a nice quick bit. You guys like, you want to hear my impression of the chili dog guy?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. I'm not big on impressions, but let me see what I can do. And it goes like this. Sucking on a chili dog, I was sucking on a chili dog. Diane's out back, she's sucking on a chili dog. Well, then there, Diane, I'm sucking on a chili dog. Diane says, baby, you're sucking on a chili dog. But Jackie says, now, oh yeah, sucking on a chili dog. Long after the thrill, well, I'm sucking on a chili dog. Oh yeah. Sucking on a chili dog. Long after the thrill, I'm sucking on a chili dog. And I usually fade it out right there. That's
yeah,
I mean.
Yeah, yeah. So then somebody did the same gag. Not like it was pretty similar.
Yeah, it was pretty much that same part of the song doing the same thing.
Right.
And so, God, that was a headache. Because immediately... I was just flooded for weeks because that his video went very viral, you know, millions.
Yeah.
They were playing it on goddamn Good Morning America and stuff, you know, like, look at this clever kid and what he came up with.
Boy.
And so it was a hard pill to swallow. And then the kid did acknowledge me on Twitter because there was everybody was saying it to him, you know, that's a Clownvis bit. That's a Clownvis bit.
Yeah.
Which was nice to it was nice to hear the world kind of sticking up for me for doing that bit so much.
Sure.
And then, so I reached out to that guy. I said, hey man, come on my show and let's do a Zoom interview face-to-face where we talk about it. And we made it fun. You know, he says it was just a case of parallel thinking. And as far as I'm concerned, it's, you know, I didn't write the song. I didn't, you know, I'm sure I'm not the first guy to laugh about the chili dog line.
Right.
And so, you know, I had him on the show. At first I acted like I was going to really rib him. And then I, broke the ice real quick and it made it fun and it turned out all right. And I made these sucking on a chili dog Clownvis t-shirts that are available at clownvistotherescue.com.
Nice.
And I've made a small fortune there. Thank you.
You know, I saw that John Cougar Mellencamp's sons beat him up one time. And this is a true story. Beat the crap out of John Cougar Mellencamp. And so you might want to be careful about any promotion of his stuff or his son's.
His son's on nasty. Yeah.
Junior Cougar Mellencamp.
Mellencamp, is he still smoking? He was always a big smoke. He's like, smoke no matter what.
I don't know. We got to Google it.
Anyways, all right, Clownvis, anything else for me today?
No, you know, that's about it, man. I'm such a big fan of your guys' show. Keep it up. Like I said, man, I'm a big fan. I'm subscribed to the High Network. I'm big into that.
Speaking of, let me promote this for a second. Big news, drum roll, boys. Give me some stereo drum rolls. Let me see who can get to it first. Drum rolls. Drum rolls. We are now offering, for those who've asked for it, monthly subscriptions to the High Network. Monthly $5 subscriptions. It's live now. Just go to highnetwork.tv and you will see all the information there. Monthly $5 subscriptions. Don't need to get the annual pass. There are some stipulations to that. There are some things that you'll probably be annoyed about, but you will have access to the site and the upcoming season and all that. So
it's well worth it, man. Money well spent. The Oscar special was fantastic.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Wish I knew what that was.
Yeah, he doesn't know. He doesn't know.
I think the Office Hours Patreon is a great way to spend a few bucks a month.
That as well.
I'm going broke over here subscribing there.
Doug and I, we actually have our own Patreons, too.
Go ahead, plug it.
Good. And hey, Matt, I'm just going to send you $20 a month, all right?
That's great. Thank you, Clownvis. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I can see why my brother Phil wastes so much of his time.
There's a lot of stuff.
Bill, do you have a Patreon, Bill? Do you have your own?
No. Well, he's got what are your interests, like comedy and music and movies and stuff?
I mean, I'm on LinkedIn, but I'm not on any other social media or anything.
No, I mean, like, what do you like? What's your scene? What do you?
I mean, I'm delivering food, so I'm a kind of foodie, I guess. You know, I kind of delve into what's good, what's, you know, good to eat, and I'm staying up.
Do you like Rush?
Do you like fan Rush?
Important question. Yeah.
No.
Do you like the Braves? Are you an Atlanta Braves?
Yeah, I like the Braves. Yeah. Yep, they're good. Yeah. Well, although my family has been banned because my brother snuck into games about 20 years ago or so. So our whole family has been blacklisted from going to any games there.
Oh, terrible. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you, Bill. You can sit again.
Yeah. Wow, it's nice to meet you.
I don't know why you're still here.
Thanks, Bill.
Please. Gotta settle up the,
I will give you the rating as soon as we're done with the show. I'm trying to stay focused here.
The rating.
Thank you, Clownvis.
Hey, thank you guys. I'm going to plug my show one more time. I go live on Sunday nights and Wednesday nights at youtube.com/ClownvisPresley, ClownvisToTheRescue.com. I love you guys.
Love you, Clownvis.
Thank you, Clownvis.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tim. Breaking Thanks, Doug. Thanks, Vic.
Breaking news that I'm getting here. Charles Grodin passed away.
No. Just,
what?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Jeez.
Well, he was very old, right? I don't know. He's old.
Yeah, he's in his 80s. I think.
So I think it was 86. A skydiving accident. 86.
Familiar face.
I'm telling you, yeah. I've talked about this before, but go watch
Beethoven and Beethoven 2.
No,
it's all about the Letterman appearances.
Yeah, no. You know what I even like better than the Letterman appearances are the Carson appearances. Yeah. They're all great. Him on Letterman and Carson, some of the greatest long form, subtle, dry, not aggressive is the word. What's the word I'm looking for? Subtle, dry. Confrontational.
Yeah, confrontational.
Mm-hmm. Uncomfortable. So good. He was, I don't know what he was really like in real life, but whatever he was doing on those shows, he decided, if I'm going to have an opportunity, if I'm a movie star, I'm in movies, and I got to go out and promote something, I'm going to make that 10 minutes I'm out there count, and I'm going to create timeless comedy. I'm not going to go out there and talk to you about what I did on my summer vacation or tell some kind of anecdote or plug. He's going to create a whole narrative, a whole back and forth. And oh my God, you can watch them all on YouTube. If you're not doing that, I don't know what you're doing. You're fucking off. You're fucking off. You're fucking rocker. You're watching too much of my shit.
Tim.
Stop watching my shit.
Tim, I had a question for you.
You have a question for me?
Yeah.
Shoot.
I know you like Clownvis, but have you ever seen Clownvis Costello?
No, is there a Clownvis Costello out there?
Why not? Maybe there should be.
Well, what would that be? Would that be...
instead of the sunglasses, it's black glasses, and he's going, I wrote the book.
Every day, I write. But why can't we add the Lou Costello element to that situation?
Yeah, get all the Costellos in here, and they're all clowns.
You could do, but I know my shit is killing you. I know my baby mentally low IQ, my low IQ is killing you. Abbott. Quiet, you. That dynamic is all fucked.
Abbott's the big one, right?
Well, he's no. What do you mean by big?
Well, typically with these guys, you got
fat, cut, easy to remember. You got
Hardy. Hardy fat. Sounds like he's the hardier, bigger one, right? And then you got, you know what I mean? It's like in the name, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, and Costello is big boy.
He's the big boy.
Child mind. He's the one that maybe lost oxygen at some point in his younger days.
And then does Abbott have a hat?
Yes.
Typically, the smaller guy's got the hat, and the fatter one's just...
They both have hats. And Lou Costello has a tiny tie that looks like a bib.
Okay, and he's got the suspenders, right? He's probably wearing bell tops.
They all have suspenders back then.
Is he wearing Steve Vai's bell tops? Anyway.
Lou Costello is like special ed. Like, he's... If you watch those movies back there, he's like not too bright. And he's always saddled with Abbott, who's got to take care of him. It's a big pain in the ass for Abbott. Abbott.
So
how does
Clownvis Costello and Clambit and Costello? How does that work?
What was the thing about? I never understood Matt, or maybe Vic knows too. What was Elvis Costello's? He had this like little brief racist period that
he was
controversial.
Drinking heavily.
Who didn't?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Yeah, and he
who didn't?
He called Ray Charles the N-word, I think, in an interview. That's in that Dark Stuff book. And he was just
what book?
The Dark Stuff by I think is Nick Kent. It was a really good read. The whole thing. It's all about like there's Elvis, I think, is in it. Jerry Lee Lewis, like all the dark periods of all these legends.
Oh, and, dark stuff.
Yeah, I want to read that book. Yeah, I think I gave you a copy, Tim. I got to find out where I put it.
I threw it in the toilet.
I know. I was gonna say
right in the toilet.
But yeah, no, there's the Jerry Lee Lewis where he's just like out of his mind. I think it's in the mid '70s, and he crashes Elvis's house, like shows up there.
Is that like most of his?
Probably.
Career?
Yeah, probably. Just like out of it.
Matt, we should take a Zoomer. It's been forever.
Yeah, I was going to go what back about a to, yeah, the Hotheads.
Oh, yeah, Hothead.
Like, we got 616.
Hotheads have not been that, great today.
Yeah,
we keep hoping for 616, you're on the line.
Will do. Thank you. Yep. Perfect. See ya.
Are they on another call? Hothead, 616, Beverly Road?
Hello?
Hello?
We tried.
Come on, let's get a Zoomer in
yeah,
here.
Yeah, let's get a Zoomer. Let's get a Zoomer.
The real
Zoomer. Who's got a friend topic, Zoom? Wave your arms around if you got something interesting to say.
I haven't talked to one member of the opposite sex, of my opposite sex.
I know. Let's talk to Olivia. You got something, Olivia?
Olivia.
Sure. Actually, I brought today because of low voter turnout. So I want to thank people for not voting.
What's this now?
Wait, what?
I got the day off to work the election, but low voter turnout, so I don't have to go in until 2. Oh, okay.
What election?
Is there? Yeah, where?
There's an election today.
Midterms. I mean, just local election stuff, school board, fun stuff.
I see. Anyway. Where?
Yeah, I'm in Oregon. Okay. Just an hour out of an hour out of Portland.
Have you got that free heroin yet? Have you gotten any of that?
Yeah, yeah, I can send some over too if you need
the good stuff. How can we help you today, Olivia?
Well, I have a game if you want.
Definitely.
Okay. So, I don't know if you're aware that IMDb has a section on each celebrity's page that is their trademark. So me and my friends will play this game where someone will pull up a celebrity, say what the trademark is, and we'll all have to guess who it is.
Can I ask a question real quick? Now, this the trademark, can it be like something they say, or is it like a piece of clothing or like anything?
Well, I'll give you an example.
Let's get an example. How about that? Let's get a...
I mean, I'm one step ahead. Don't worry.
What?
For example, Ed Helms, his trademark on IMDb is often plays characters who appear meek at first, but show their strength in the end.
Oh boy. Well, I would never guess that.
A trademark, it sounds like.
As let's see.
What about like a top hat and a cane would be Charlie Chaplin?
The Joker would be Jack Nicholson.
Trademark. This changed since I looked last night.
Is this game in beta still?
The trademarks are changing.
So last night when I compiled these to prepare, Jack Black's trademark was stocky frame. But now his trademark is starts speaking in a low, quiet tempo and begins to sing in a faster, louder cadence.
Wow.
All right, well, let's play. I like this game.
So, I compiled some people that that have worked, or you've starred alongside, or have been on the show, or both.
Okay, that's nice. It narrows it down.
Oh. So, okay, first one.
Let's hear it for Olivia for coming.
Yeah, this is prepared. Thank you.
We should say that for game night.
Oh, by the way, game night, Matt, what, Friday?
Friday, and it's a full stream crossover with world record podcast, A-Train and B-Man.
There you go.
Lots of fun.
That's this Friday.
This Friday, patrons Walsh. Only, Brandon Walsh.
Brandon Walsh.
Amanda.
Okay, Olivia, B-Man. Hit us B-Man up. Let's do our best. Now, Vic, remember, this could be somebody that's been on the show or somebody that I've worked with, somebody in the wider Heidecker universe.
Got it.
Okay. Curly brown hair.
Rob Schneider.
Oh, John C. Reilly.
Yes!
Thank you. I get a point.
Ooh, okay. Doug's on fire already, early out of the gate.
All right. Next is low-key sardonic sense of humor.
Zach Galifianakis.
No. This one also changed because I think last night this one was piercing green eyes. So I'll give you that.
Low-key sardonic humor. Fred Armisen.
No. Unfortunately, he has no trademark.
That sounds like Zach. Doesn't that sound like Zach? Doesn't he have piercing green eyes?
Well, there's many people with a low-key sardonic.
Sure. But piercing green eyes.
Man or woman?
Narrow it down.
A man.
Bill, low-key sardonic humor, piercing green eyes. I have to pass.
Let's bring Shemp and Jack Flash. You have a...
You got somebody with a guess in the audience?
I think Shemp and Jack Flash has a guess.
Oh, Glazer, John Glazer.
Paul Rudd?
No. Oh, wait.
Is it Paul Rudd?
Shemp and Jack has.
Yes.
Paul Rudd. Shemp and Jack Flash.
Paul Rudd.
Sorry, my internet's shitty.
Who got it? John, you said it's Paul Rudd?
Paul Rudd.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Okay.
Shemp and Jack Flash got it. Congrats.
Okay.
Next.
I don't know about this game, dude. It's still in beta, Doug.
Hair. This is...
Wait, what was it again?
Short hair.
Short hair.
Trademark short hair?
Producer Matt.
No.
Trademark short hair.
Is it a male?
It's a woman.
There we go.
Pignataro.
No. Shorter hair.
A lot of diet.
Ellen DeGeneres? No.
No, shorter than that.
A lot of dead air in
this. Dionne Warwick.
Friends with George Bush.
No, she doesn't have a trademark, unfortunately.
Well, I'm thinking Sarah Squirm, but I don't think she would have a
trademark. No, she's not going to. Dionne Warwick does have a trademark. Right. Sarah Squirm doesn't have one.
Okay, I'll clarify. She hasn't been on the show.
Oh,
okay. But
Maria Bamford?
Sinead O'Connor?
No.
Short hair,
Susan Powder,
shorter than Pignataro.
Right, that workout woman. Mm-hmm. Jamie Lee Curtis,
Pat Benatar.
Oh, Kirstie Alley from Star Trek II, where she plays the Vulcan. She's a bald head. No, that's not Kirstie Alley.
Kirstie Alley.
Thank you, Brian. Maria Bamford was a good guess.
I don't know.
I don't get this.
Yeah, this game is.
Wow. We gave up. It's too hard. Next game, next Zoomer.
Sometimes we say the name first and you have to guess the trademark.
But who is it?
Oh, Lupita Nyong'o.
Who?
Oh, yeah, from us, Lupita. Wow. All right, okay. All right. One more, please.
okay, this one's a very easy one. Their trademark is invariably appears shirtless when playing Vladimir Putin on Saturday Night Live.
Beck Bennett.
Okay, that didn't count, really.
It's not Beck Bennett?
It wasn't Beck Bennett? It was.
Oh.
Yeah. All right.
Thanks,
well,
Olivia.
Thank you, Olivia.
That was fun.
I enjoyed that game. I don't know about anybody else, but I sure did. And isn't that all that counts?
It needs a little structure. It needs a timer or something.
Okay.
It's better than Vic's middle name game.
Thanks, Olivia. Come on. Let's talk to Devin and his. Is that an alligator?
I can pull it up.
Look at Devin's alligator. You guys seeing this? Center that gator's face.
Talking about UFOs. That's from another planet, that sucker.
Found him on Mars. Elon Musk took me. And
what is that?
It looks like a snake almost.
It's a lizard.
It's a blue-tongued skink.
Oh, what are you doing with that, skink, man?
Why do you have such a big lizard?
Is that legal?
The girlfriend seems to like it.
Where are you, Florida?
Does it have teeth?
It's got little, like, nub teeth, but he doesn't like me very much.
How big is that thing going to get?
He's very slinky, but he'll probably keep growing. I don't know, like maybe 25 inches.
What do you feed it?
This is going to sound dumb, but they eat canned dog food and like fruits and vegetables and bugs.
Why is that dumb? Makes sense.
Can you like sit and watch TV and like cuddle with it, or does it just do that shit all the time?
It's got very sharp nails.
Oh, God.
I get dog. No. I mean,
why do you have a reptile as a pet?
At this point, I would have put it back. That's not for me.
I get people that have dogs. I have a
dog. I do have a dog here, too.
I'm not crazy about dogs. I don't need to have a dog. I have a dog, whatever. Kids like it. Cats, okay, I get. People like Matt likes cats. He does his kitty of the day. But anything else is just nuts.
Yeah, unless you're like 10.
I think why do you have a reptile? That skink would make a nice belt, maybe.
Yeah, no, that's why I'm growing him.
22. I would need a 32-inch skink, though.
Right. No,
send me
sure.
A pair. Nice send one, me Matt. A pair of shoes, buddy. Would you?
He's still in beta right now.
Maybe baby shoes. You could get your
couple
kids
of
shoes.
A pair of loafers.
Yeah. I'm actually going to make him into a hat.
There you go.
Eventually.
You need a 24-inch skink to get two feet of shoes.
You ever see that people like they stuff their dogs or cats when they die and then they like, make?
I told you this happened to my parents where they were.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Living in this condominium in Florida, and they didn't allow big dogs. So this guy had his dog put down and stuff.
Oh my God, dude.
I was like,
that's dark.
You're a psychopath. You're a bad person.
Thanks, Devin. Take care of that skink.
Thanks, guys.
By the way, I'm in the market for a dog, I think. I think I'm ready to get one.
You're back?
Really?
Really?
That's great.
That's a commitment, though.
That sounds good, man. You're over the loss of Bug.
Well, you guys have kids and stuff. So.
Yeah.
I need some kind
I'll
of
loan you my
we
kids.
Got a full house.
So if anyone's out there and want to unload a dog,
there you go.
Unload.
Unload a couple.
All right.
What kind of dog are you going to get? Yeah, a small dog?
Well, I already have the doggy doors installed, so I can't get anything bigger than wood. I don't want to have to
size the doggy doors.
I understand.
So medium to small, you know, not like, it doesn't have to be a tiny, it's got to be something that could go camping, maybe, not like be a food for a coyote, but it could be small.
Let's try 616 on the hothead line again. They called back. Let's give them one last try.
Okay.
Are you there, 616?
Oh, yeah!
Wow.
You got David Lee Roth on the line?
What's the deal with this? Oh, yes, you bet your ass it is. What's the deal with this fucking canal shit, huh? We're not talking about the Panama one? Panama!
Coming in hot, 616.
Yeah, I don't know. Is there something that happened with the Panama Canal?
No, it was this fucking San Juan whatever one. Why are we not talking about the Panama Canal?
I don't know. What's there to say? It does a good. It you can travel through it easily. It's it's a eighth wonder of the world. I mean, you learned a little bit about the bill. I mean, obviously, it was very controversial because the United States government and the way that they meddled in there to take over that land in Panama. You know, actually, I don't know if you know this. Colombia had that whole land. And then they kind of, the United States paid these rebels, people to take over that little isthmus there and create Panama so that we could control everything down there. And Jimmy Carter gave it all away. Good for him.
Tim, you know what a Panama is, right?
Well, you know a lot more about it than I do. Now I just feel like a fool.
Yeah. What's a Panama, Doug? It's a hat?
It's kind of like an enema, but it's more artisan. It's a Panama. Do it at the campsite.
I'll tell you my funny food story from last night. I went to dinner by myself last night at this French place next door to the hotel, and they do crepes. They do savory crepes.
What?
Crepes. Aren't they called crepes?
No, if you're like me and you're like educated, French. You're cultured, you call them crepes.
Oh, okay.
People call them crepes, I call them crepes. Other educated Frenchmen like myself call them crepes. So I order a chicken crepe, okay? And the menu says chicken and cream and mushrooms. Doesn't that sound nice? You know? Kind of a cream of chicken and mushroom. I get this thing out, and I start gobbling away. I'm like, this is delicious. It's a little spicy. And I'm not even thinking about it, because frankly, I had a couple beers. And I'm just eating this thing, shoving it in my mouth. The waiter comes out. He goes, I'm so sorry. We gave you the seafood. We gave you the seafood crepe. I'll say crepe for you, so you understand what I'm talking about. We accidentally gave you the seafood crepe. I go, as soon as it hit, I'm like, it does taste like, doesn't taste like chicken and mushrooms at all. This is shrimp and scallops.
I mean, that's like how IKEA was serving those meatballs to everybody.
Yeah.
Thinking they were cow, but it was all horse. It's all
horse. Oh, IKEA meatballs are horse?
It's a real thing. It's a real, yeah.
But anyways.
You could just be eating anything.
I could not, this allegedly. Is what a magnanimous guy I am. Wonderful person I am. I said, you know what? I'm actually enjoying this. It's totally fine. They couldn't believe. They were stunned. They go, we're so sorry. We brought you the wrong plate. Don't you understand? It's a complete disaster. We're all ready to commit Harry Carey over here. Because what happened? What are you telling me?
Is everything okay? They comp it?
They come back. The manager comes over. I'm so sorry. I just heard what happened. Are you sure there's nothing we can do? I said, you know what? It's fine. Life is not perfect, and I'm happy. I'm happy with this crepe.
Happy as a clam.
And I rolled with it. I said, you know what? It's all good.
Yeah, but if that was a horse crepe, you'd be raising hell.
Well, the waiter said, listen, what if you were allergic to seafood? We'd be in real trouble.
Oh, that's a good point.
Yeah, you see, you know what? Maybe I am. I can use a couple of bucks. Why don't we settle this out of court? I'm allergic. I'm hella allergic.
Hella allergic.
Just give me all the take from tonight's till, and we'll call it even.
Hey, does Bill want to say goodbye to Phil real quick?
Sure. Bill, you want to say goodbye to your brother?
He's still Wes, can we bring Phil up? But let's keep him muted. I don't want to let him speak.
Matt wants you to wave goodbye. He's pissed.
Oh, he's in there.
Yeah, he's real pissed.
See you later,
Bill,
I guess.
Bill, can you scooch to your left? Get in the frame. Bill, scooch to your left.
Stage left.
Can't hear anything.
Oh, Tim, can you pull Bill in there real quick? Pull Bill in.
Pull Bill to the center, Tim. Center.
Yeah, here. Come in the middle.
Yeah, what?
Well, he's muted, but I figured you could say goodbye to Phil.
Oh, well, yeah, I guess we'll see you Christmas time or something. I don't know, but call me or text me or whatever. Sorry, dude. Just doing my job here. I don't know what you're so worked up about. But.
He looks pissed.
Yeah, he's muted because he's on probation. So
he's so angry.
Yeah, he's pissed. He's seething.
Thank you, Bill. I want to give Bill let me get my phone. I don't have my phone because it's being used as a camera right now. Oh, so
all right.
I'll give you a 5-star review.
Thank you.
Just hit the fan on the way out, okay?
You should go bathroom. With him and like take and deliver some food with him.
Me? No, yeah, I have an after-hour show to do.
Okay.
Tim, I got a food story to tell you for an after hours.
That's a great thing because it is time to go to after hours. Thank you to Clownvis and Bill Braun and all our wonderful guests. We're going to be continuing the conversation over at patreon.com/officehourslive. I'll see you there in 2 minutes.
Are you ready?
Peace out. All the best.
Massive dumps. Nobody's ever seen anything like
Don't get me all stirred.
Okay, guys.
Can you do a horse?
Good.
Do you want to see the horse? You want to see the horse? Okay, you can see the horse.
Do you want to see the horse?
I'm like getting the feeling of coming in the gym. I'm getting the feeling of coming at home. I'm coming day and night.
I masturbate a lot.
I'm not masturbating.
I masturbate a lot.
I had a beat off. I'm not masturbating.